As we try to understand what is the right pump for our system, we need to understand our system hydraulics and our system performance first. And to do that, we create what is known as the system curve. To help develop this idea, I have this general, very vague schematic of a pumping system where we have a reservoir on a lower elevation pumping up to the reservoir on a higher elevation in the middle of the pump. The main tool that we use is conservation of energy. And in this case, it's just like when you go to solve energy between two known points, except we add in the term of the what they call the pump head into the equation. This equation can be simplified because the starting and ending points are open air reservoirs, where essentially the velocity of the flow is at rest, right? So we can cancel out the velocity 1, the velocity 2. Also, if you take a second to think about it, both reservoirs are at the same pressure, whatever it is, they will also be canceled out because they're the equal. So we can solve this equation for what is often referred to as the pump head by moving Z1 over to the right-hand side and being left with these terms, Z2 minus Z1 plus the friction head loss plus the minor head losses. If we start inserting values into this, you know, we have on this particular example the Darcy-Weisbach friction factor given to us. So we'll use the Darcy-Weisbach equation. It provides us the opportunity to bring in Q into the equation, or the flow rate. We can also ignore the minor losses for now, because in a system that's fairly large, the minor losses usually don't add up to much over the whole of the system. So knowing that we're going to use Darcy-Weisbach, we can actually put in the specific values that were given to us in the problem and calculate the pump head in terms of the elevation head plus some factor times the Q, times the flow rate. So that gets us this equation, where now we can simplify it down to H of P is equal to 30 feet, that's the elevation head we need to overcome, plus the friction head that we need to overcome. So if you're doing this all by yourself, go ahead and take a moment, stop right now, calculate that factor and insert it into that space next to the Q squared. Did you happen to get 15.8? I hope so. Be handy if you did, then I know I did it right. What this does for us is it gives us a way to plot all the performance of the system as the discharge in the system varies. So on your handout, you can fill in the flow rates at 500, 1,000, 1,500, 2,000, 2,500, so forth, so that you can have the x-axis values ready to go. Darcy-Weisbach equation uses Q in cubic feet per second. So we take our gallons per minute and insert in all the CFS values. And now that we have the CFS values, we can use our system curve equation to tell us what is the corresponding head that needs to be overcome in the system. With this information, we can go ahead and start plotting that on our graph. This is the scale I plan to use. And just plot these points in. It's going to be a nice parabolic shape related to the fact that we've got a Q squared term. And this sort of gives you an overview of how to create a system curve. The system curve equation, just as a quick review, comes from the conservation of energy formula. We can cancel out the pressures and the velocities, and then we just solve the pump head in terms of all the other terms so that we get down to a pump head plus the elevation difference, or pump head equals the elevation difference plus some factor times Q squared. And we need to know this before we can do anything related to finding the right pump